These are my prescription pants.
They were made to fit my body exactly by using a 3D scan that I made with my phone. They were made by this company, and now they've developed a 3D robot loom that can basically make clothing on demand.
We can produce products that are made to fit you differently than they're made to fit me.
Every single person who's come through the door has said, my legs are too short, my calves are too big.
They're fantastic legs. Yeah. It's the pants that have been the problem.
Exactly.
What if the future of fashion is the ability to buy clothing that fits you perfectly every time? Why do this? Well, it turns out fashion is one of the most wasteful industries on the planet.
Apparel has just been built around 20% waste is okay, because that's really all we could do in that old method.
There are significantly deeper issues that we're talking about here. It's not just a pair of pants.
Technologies like this mean we could get better clothes that fit us perfectly with much less waste.
It's really difficult to appreciate our clothing because we haven't made it. We're missing that whole picture.
Come see how it works. This is Hard Reset, a series about rebuilding our world from scratch. I came to visit the folks at Unspun, where they've reinvented one of the oldest technologies in human history, the loom.
The whole system that we're creating is trying to go back to the beginning of why clothing should exist and how it should exist in the world.
This is Beth Espinette, and you could say Unspun literally grew out of her garden.
I planted a dress warm in my garden, and there were chia seeds all over it. And it grew into this beautiful, well, beautiful. It depends on who you ask. These snails thought it was very beautiful, a nice vest.
They're a market too.
Yes. Yes, they really ate it up, literally.
The chia vest was not destined for mass manufacturing, but it got them moving in the right direction.
It brought us back to additive manufacturing. That felt right, mm-hmm. Building from the ground up. But the materials that we were using weren't the right ones to be commercial.
This is Kevin, one of the co-founders of Unspun, and as far as we know, he doesn't make chia clothes.
So Unspun is building a very different method of apparel production by fundamentally just rethinking all of the steps involved in the process. The specific approach that we're taking to that is three-dimensional weaving, going from very flat conventional weaving to a much more 3D and seamless process.
The core of our technology takes yarn, three-dimensionally builds the garment from the ground up, so it's an edited process, it's automated, it's fast.
This is Walden, another co-founder. Normally, we spread out our introductions, but we're doing them all at the beginning, so we can weave them together through the piece. Get it? Weave them together? Never mind. Anyway, it's tempting to think of this as something like a 3D printer for clothes, but it's not that. It's just a loom that works in three dimensions, not two.
The difference is really that we're taking the exact same yarns that are in your jeans or your dress shirt or your jacket, putting those into a machine and just building a seamless product in this 3D form.
The loom can weave seamless tubes. Those tubes get sewn together to make pants or shirts. Also, this is a jacquard loom. Each strand can be controlled individually. That allows for intricate patterns to be woven into the cloth.
It's a 3D weave, so it doesn't have any inseam and no outseam, so it's just kind of a full piece. Jacquard means that every single yarn that's on the machine is controlled individually. So you're not stuck with a plain weave pattern, for example. You can start to build in different patterns. You can even write your name in it.
This is a bit of a full circle. The first jacquard looms date back to 1803, and the punch cards that programmed their weaving patterns were a foundational technology that helped inspire programmable computers. Thank Ada Lovelace the next time you look at your phone, because all the electronics you rely on today are the distant descendants of software she wrote for those punch cards. Thank you, Ada. Now, software is powering and coordinating little robots inside a loom to do things that were previously unimaginable. This is such a new technology that we weren't allowed to film the guts of it, but I was able to look at it and describe it to you.
Basically, it's like a donut of robot parts that are taking a whole ton of threads and weaving them up and down really fast as these carts of thread circle around and weave it all together. It's actually really hypnotic to watch.
Weaving is a very precise technology, we are communicating signals within millimeters of each other in terms of weaving instructions.
Rather than things mechanically being timed, we're now timing everything with really robust software. Our machine operates much more like an autonomous car in terms of the control systems inside of it than the even advanced looms of the last decade.
We've got some product here from our newer machine, and I would describe this as just denser, really good coverage. So that's really the biggest difference, is there are about four times as many yarns being used in this product, so it's higher density.
The result is that this machine can make garments that produce far less waste and can be custom made to fit your body. Eventually, you could upload a 3D scan of your body and have garments woven specifically to fit you.
This is where we're finally getting to that economical point where 3D weaving is now just as affordable and significantly faster than a very manual cut and sew labor process done on the opposite side of the world.
One pair of pants is like 10 minutes of manufacturing.
Yeah, it's 10 minutes on machine, and then we have finishing steps that are fewer than 10 minutes.
The way clothes get made now is pretty nuts.
Apparel manufacturing, conventionally, is cotton grown in a field. It goes to a factory that, you know, filters and processes the fiber, twists those fibers, spins them, and that factory sells these yarns to another factory, putting them on these big beams and then weaving them together to create this flat fabric to another factory who's buying that fabric, laying it out, cutting out these like cookie cutter part. Waste just gets thrown away at 10 or 15% of all of the fiber up to that point. Cookie cutter pieces and stitch them together and you have a pair of pants.
Each step in this process has waste and pollution. There's water pollution from dyes or excess fabric scraps and overproduction that gets landfilled or incinerated.
The weird thing is there is so little transparency within the industry that nobody can really agree on the impact. Depending on the sources that you trust, the fashion industry accounts for roughly about 4 to 10% of global human carbon emissions.
Apparel is top three, top five dirtiest industries in the world. The bulk of that is not necessarily billowing smoke out of factories. It's an industry that has just become so standardized on waste.
During any season, you typically are landfilling or incinerating 25, even up to 30% of the garments because there is a mismatch between demand and supply.
30% is a lot. Like, imagine building houses and then burning 30% of them down because they didn't sell. Or just erasing 30% off the end of your video. See? No bueno.
This becomes hundreds of billions of dollars spent to make something, move it around the world a couple times, it doesn't get sold and is ultimately shredded or burned or landfilled.
And people in this industry know it's a problem.
Seeing that was super devastating for me because I had lived my whole life thinking it's this glamorous industry, it's really good for everyone, and actually wasn't.
If you were going to hard reset this process, you might start by making an automated three-dimensional loom. I mean, that's what I would do, but the folks at Unspun did it first. Anyway, with this approach, a yarn can be made directly into a garment in a single location, and it can be made on demand to fit you perfectly. There's no scraps, no overproduction, and a lot less international shipping.
In clothing, we saw an opportunity to build something additively and even in an automated way, so that you could do it when someone wants it. You could have it on demand. And by changing the manufacturing method, you could also inform what the recycling method would be. So if you're very thoughtful about, let's weave these yarns together and not really hurt the yarns while you're doing it, then you could go backwards at the end of the life and unravel those back into some spools and reuse them. So this is an example of a material that was woven and then rewoven again. Oh, wow. So the yarn stayed intact for the life of the product and then was able to go back on the machine again.
That's really fascinating. This is on its second life as a product.
Exactly, yeah. It was a skirt before and now it's a pair of shorts.
Environmental impacts aside, how will this affect the way you buy or wear clothes? Well, for most people, the biggest impact might just be clothes that actually fit them.
One of the original inspirations for the company was I was passing through this Olympic stadium. They have a picture of all the Olympians, and it's really shocking how diverse the body types are. Like if you walk into a normal fast retail store, there is no way you can find fitting garments for every one of them. These are people top of the game, and still you cannot find fitting garments for this small group of people. And if you extrapolate that to the world population, then it just becomes a shocking problem.
Does every product need to just fit you? Probably not. I'm relatively happy with my socks. Most of the time, a medium t-shirt or a large t-shirt fits me, but just about everybody can tell you a story of not being able to find something that fit.
For example, me.
Bad guy in a little coat.
Also me. And this too is me.
Don't fix me! God damn it!
Currently, clothes are mass-produced with standard sizing. Shockingly, this system originated in the Civil War to make it easier to manufacture uniforms.
Originally, it was done using the military because they were the ones they could force them to take all their measurements. And then in the late 30s, the USDA paid money to survey women, and that became the standard for decades.
Standard sizing, at the end of the day, isn't even standard. It's not about helping you find clothes that fit, it's about making them cheaper to make and easier to sell.
The whole reason sizes exist is because manufacturing things or a lot of slightly different things adds a lot of complexity to the process. It's so much more manageable when it's just software and robotics producing something than trying to, you know, align the production process of hundreds of humans working on the same thing.
What if your clothing size was unique to you? What if everyone had mass-manufactured clothes that fit like they were custom-tailored to them? That's possible, and not just in a Back to the Future movie.
This thing doesn't fit.
I'm disgusting.
Unspun made a proof-of-concept version of this, which allows you to scan your body using your phone. They use the 3D data to create a custom-fitted pair of jeans. I tried it, and it was really delightful to put on a pair of jeans that just fit. Hopefully, this is what all shopping will be like in the future.
Our vision is on-demand manufacturing. And for us, it came to, we can prove on-demand is here through this custom fit proof of concept brand, where we take a 3D scan of your body and then build you a garment just like that.
This proof of concept was developed before the 3D loom was ready to go. So these jeans were made the traditional way. But in the future, it's possible to combine these technologies to create truly personal clothing for everyone. We mentioned earlier that the loom is one of our oldest technologies, but an even older one is shaving. Just like Unspun has rethought the loom, our sponsor for this video, Henson Shaving, has challenged all our assumptions about shaving. Razor companies have spent decades and millions of dollars convincing you that you need lots of gimmicky blades to get a smooth shave. But they ignore the impacts on your skin. Well, Henson turned that around. Imagine a nice smooth shave that keeps your skin safe. Two-thirds of men say they expect some irritation when they shave, but it doesn't actually have to be that way. Henson's research shows that most modern razor blade cartridges are just not supporting their blades well enough. All those little variances can have a huge impact on the quality and consistency of a shave. Well, with their 20-plus years of experience in aerospace machining, Henson made a razor that is super well-supported and precise. Personally, I insist on aerospace precision when I put a sharp blade anywhere near my face. You should too, because it doesn't just make it better at shaving, it allows you to get a good shave without damaging your skin. I really love my Henson razor. It's easily the best razor I've ever owned. It uses standard, affordable blades that are totally recyclable, so there's no waste like disposable cartridges. If you want a precise shaving experience that protects your skin, go to hensonshaving.com/hardreset. If you buy a razor and a pack of 100 blades like this, just enter the code RESET and you will get the blades for free. 100 blades like this, by the way, will last you a few years, so this is a great way to hard reset your shaving regimen. Sponsored section over, let's get back to custom clothes. So picture a scenario where robotic looms made our clothes, on demand, and they always fit perfectly. These robotic looms are small and nimble, and with minimal labor, they can distribute clothing manufacturing to more places around the world, maybe even in every city.
So if we're closer to where demand is, we're close to where the consumer is buying the product, it makes that on-demand model possible.
In a world where we have this distributed microfactory system all across the United States, we can produce 100,000 for a massive factory, but we could also produce 10 for a local brand. So I think the shift is going to move away from these big, mega, centralized, popular brands to a much more distributed world of lots of different design and expression, because that fundamental barrier of manufacturing starts to be lowered.
Imagine walking into a store, getting scanned, and walking out with a dress or pair of pants that was made only for you. This isn't just about it fitting you properly. It could actually change your whole relationship with your clothes.
Currently, how we think about apparel is it's disposable. With our technology, the products are more durable, so that in 2 years, when fashion cycles, inevitably they will come back, that those could be reused, but you can still have that optionality of self-expressing in a culturally relevant manner.
What we have should have value, no matter if it's day one or day, 5,000 of its use. Is there a way that we can start to think about what we make in this world not being trash at the end of life? Can we kind of reframe that?
I'm going to start with the spin and then say these are my prescription pants. Oh, damn. Something like, what's that? Yeah, I'll do a backflip and you'll call the ambulance and it'll all be fine.